Guys, we're going to have to do another one of these. there's nothing to talk about now. Everyone's talking about the stupid fucking riots and bullshit. Who wants to hear about that anymore? I'm sick of that crap. So today, we got a great post, guys, from the polyamory Reddit, whatever the fuck you call it. This is new to being poly and having issues. Hello, all. Over quarantine, my wife, 23 female, and I, 22 male, opened our relationship up to polyamory. I think he's trying to say polyamory. After a few dates and a few partners, I'm finding myself feeling left out. I'm noticing a trend. All these guys, they always seem to be feeling left out. And I'm coming here for advice. My wife and I were each other's first and only. We've been together for almost 7 years now. 7 years? Isn't that when most people break up? I don't know, that's something I've always heard. I don't know if that's true. Several years back, I developed a cuckold fetish. Well, that's not good. That's never good. Which planted the seed of opening our relationship up to other people. Now back to the present. My wife has been on a few dates with a few different people. Each of those men had no interest in meeting me. I don't want to meet that dork. I just want to throw it in your butt a few times. Can we skip the whole meeting of the dork thing? That'd be great. When it comes to those dates, I find myself able to handle the anxiety just fine. But when it comes to them having sex, I get panic attacks and a serious case of FOMO. FOMO, you're a FOMO. I had to look up what FOMO meant, and it means fear of missing out. This FOMO is definitely partially from my cuckold fetish, but I'm still struggling with it. He wants to sit in the room while his wife gets pounded. Hey, why won't they let me do that? I think what I want is a third person in our relationship that is romantically involved with my wife, but okay with me being involved on the sexual side. What a dude, right? Is there a term for this? Yeah, there's tons of terms. One rhymes with FOMO. Am I ridiculous for wanting that? Like, is it just a porn fantasy? Or have we not met the right people? Why do people get so messed up? What did it all go so bad? I feel like I'm just giving and giving to make these dates happen for her and not getting anything in return. I've drove 2 hours and sat and waited around for them to be done. He has to deliver the bitch to these dudes like a pizza. I'll be there in 15 minutes. I've stayed home and cleaned house in case he comes back. Oh, I hope my souffle is ready. And I've done a lot of emotional labor. A dude shouldn't say emotional labor. That's bitch talk. Emotional labor. Shut up. To be okay with what has already happened. If I could at least get my rocks off, I'd be happy. But I'm getting pushed back on the one thing I'm asking for. If they plan to stay together forever, these two idiots. How is that bitch ever gonna let this guy live it down that he delivered her like a pizza to all these dudes? You know what I mean? Like that, I'd imagine the mental image of that just never goes away. Him waiting out in the car while she's getting railed. There's no way they're good. They're probably already broken up. They're probably already done. To sum it all up, I'm feeling left out because I can't meet these men and I'm being excluded from my favorite part, the sex. I feel bad expecting to be present or get photos. Yeah, put it in her asshole. I got the Kodak. I got the Kodak! And peeing on their alone time. But at the same time, I've gotten almost nothing from opening up our relationship. Well, what did you think was going to... What do these guys ever think is going to happen? And when I ask to be present or get pictures, my wife resists. Hey, can I get a couple shots of that? This whole thing is ridiculous. Having her resist makes me feel like I'm in the wrong for wanting that. You are in the wrong. Your wife or whatever is a piece of shit too. But if I never get it, then I feel like I'm not enjoying being poly. Please, I beg of you, before you jump to any conclusions, ask for clarification. I'm not that good at writing, and my tone might easily be taken completely wrong. I don't know, I knew you were a douche when you said cuckold fetish, and you didn't even write that much at that point. Well, what an adventure, guys. What did we learn? I think we all learned something. But hey, I'll see you later or something.